right, so this is a suggestion via donation. The name of the song is This Is America by the artist Childish Gambino. Listen, if you guys are new here, please like and subscribe. The more that you like this content, the more that I know that you specifically would like to see more of this specific type of content, okay? So we have the lyrics pulled up just in case we need them, all right? Let's check this out, guys. All right, This Is America. Like the music almost sounds like West African inspired, almost like not really Afrobeat, but like definitely West African inspired, or maybe Caribbean inspired, but most likely West African inspired. But we're here. Oh, that's the, bro, this is the dude from, what's his damn show, guys? From Community. Why does he have no shirt on, though, bro? Okay, hold on. So the guy from the Community is Childish Gambino. Okay. So a guy sits down in a chair with a guitar. The scene basically, like, the camera cuts away, and then now he's back with like his head wrapped up as he decides to hold on. Out of his waistband. One-handed pull a weapon that is hammer fired, yes, with a hammer, and aim it at the guy, and then proceed to extinguish. What is happening, bro? This is America. Then a kid comes out of nowhere. Wait, what? Don't catch you slipping. No. Don't catch you slipping. No. Okay. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Don't catch you slipping up. Look what I'm whipping up. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. That droning bass line is... it's interesting. This is America. Don't catch you slipping up. Look how I'm living up. Police be tripping up. Yeah, this is America. Okay, listen, as of right now, like, visually, it's giving me kind of a headache. Mainly because, like, the focal point, obviously, is the artist himself. But there's, like, things going on in the background here, guys. Like, a lot of things going on in the background. Don't catch you slipping, no. Normally, when you're filming a video, you don't allow that to happen, guys. Don't catch you slipping, no. Look what I'm whipping, no. This is America. Got you slipping up. Look how I'm living up. Police be tripping up. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. Hey, I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like, yeah. Yeah, I'm so dull like, yeah. We gon' blow like, yeah. Oh, we got a choir, bro? All right. Why does he have no shirt on, bro? Bro, what did he just... Hold on, bro. Hold on, bro. Saw that coming when he grabbed the... It was AK-47. Listen, Okay, he's trying to make a point here, bro. He's trying to make a point. I feel like we need to actually go back a whole lot. So hopefully you guys are not too angry. We're going to go back a little bit because I think that he's... there's like a disconnect from the actual music itself and the visuals that are showing. Okay, and firstly, the pants that he's wearing, they're not normal, guys. They look like Confederate soldier pants, guys. I think he's trying to prove a point. I think we're missing things, guys. If you don't mind, apologies. We can go back just a little bit right after he extinguished the guy's life because we don't need to see that again, right? We understand that. Okay, so he hands it off to a kid that holds it in like a... All right. Don't catch you slipping, though. Don't catch you slipping, though. Look what I'm whipping, though. This isn't normal, guys. I generally don't go all the way back, guys. This is America. Don't catch you slipping, though. Don't catch you slipping, though. Look what I'm whipping, though. Gotta watch everything, I think. Don't catch you slipping, though. Look how I'm living, though. Police be tripping now. Yeah, this is America. Guns in my area. I got the strap. Hey, I gotta carry 'em. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go into this. Yeah, yeah, this is gorilla. Yeah, yeah, I'ma go get the bag. Yeah, yeah, or I'ma get the pad. Yeah, yeah, I'm so cold like yeah. All right, so in the beginning, he basically extinguished the guy's life, and he was very nonchalantly handed the tool off to a kid that had the gun basically wrapped up. All right, while he's wearing like Confederate soldier pants and two chains reference? No, it can't be. Maybe bondage reference? Could he be referring to bondage? Chains, bondage? No, no, we'll figure this out, I'm sure. What's interesting is that I think he is a distraction. Right, I think he is himself acting as a distraction while all of this crazy ridiculousness is going on in the background. I think his dance moves are purely rooted in getting your attention away from what's actually happening. You may think that he is happy, but behind him is all this just craziness deep within, maybe. Yeah, I'm so dull, yeah. There's somebody back there with a money machine. Lola, yeah. And this scene here, the choir, then he goes, and this right here is, I'm guessing, referencing the thing that happened in Charleston, Dylann Roof. I still don't understand the shirtless thing, though, guys. This is America. Don't catch you slipping, no. Okay, and then again, he extinguished lives with an automatic AK-47. All right. He must have a crazy license. Probably not, right? Because the people who are generally doing these things are not legal gun holders. They're criminals in the first place. So keep that in mind, right? All right. But so he hands this illegal, somehow automatic firearm to another guy who basically wraps it up and runs off. Maybe he's pointing out, maybe he's trying to say at least, that America treats the weapons most likely better than the people who have their lives extinguished by them. Okay, that's his opinion. All right. It's the same red cloth that he used to take the pistol. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. This is America. Don't catch you slipping now. There's chaos going on in the background while we're supposed to look at him, I'm guessing. Don't catch you slipping now. Look what I'm whipping now. Look how I'm geeking now. I'm so fitted. I'm on Gucci. I'm so pretty. Look at my outfit. Look at how pretty I am. Look at the brands that I wear. While all this is going on in the background is basically what he is saying, and most likely, yeah, what's going on in the background. Yeah. I'm gonna get it. The riot almost. Watch me move. This is selling. That's a tool. Yeah. This is a celly, that's a tool. Celly, a cell, a jail cell. That's a tool. A tool to, oh, okay, 13th Amendment is what he's referring to, obviously, in that instance. But also at the same time, the cell phone is a tool to record bad deeds, most likely, yes, that are occurring. All right, we're here. This is Sully. That's a tool. Yeah. On my Kodak. Ooh, black. Ooh, know that. Yeah. Ooh, get it. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Ooh, get it. He's like doing all the like popular dances. Why is there a horse? What does a horse represent? Why, is it the white horse of the apocalypse? Is that what that is? He's saying that the that America will fall or is falling or has fallen, right? All right, the white horse is a symbol, the biblical symbol for the apocalypse. What? Okay, hold on, guys. He's making a, for some reason he thinks he's holding a weapon for some reason, but I wouldn't hold it like that, sir. All right, not like that. But either way, as soon as he did that, everyone basically scattered. He has to plug into Oaxaca. They're gonna find you like Blaka, right? As in the sound of a gun, right? Whoa, right. They're gonna find you like Blaka Blah. Alright. The screaming in the background. Everyone has left him? is he in there by himself now? Alright. He lights up a joint. America. I just checked my following, listen. You motherfuckers owe me. Okay, so the guy's back. What is happening here? Was this a dream, maybe? Maybe it was a dream. Maybe what was happening before everyone scattered and ran away, maybe that was a dream. Is that SZA? All right. He's dancing in a warehouse, on top of cars, and they're all like 80s, 90s vehicles. Okay. Bro, who is that singing? Like, is that, that's not him, is it? It sounds like Young Thug. And that's not a good thing. That's not a good thing at all. He's like, okay, now it's dark completely in the warehouse and he's just running. But he's being chased. It's like, is this like Get Out or something? A reference to Get Out, maybe? All right. Okay, this is America. And he was acting as if he was America, I think, right? So he specifically was America. Look at my cool dances, Gucci. Look at how pretty I am. But don't look behind me. Don't look too deep, all right? Because if you look too deep, you see this, right? As the white horse of the apocalypse rides through the scene. Guys... All right. I mean, visually, it was a very good video, obviously. I mean, there's a lot of deep meanings. I'm sure I didn't get any of it, right? I'm sure, like, I don't know any of it, but maybe I've, I don't know. I'm sure I'm missing pieces, right? I'm going to have to watch it again and think about it. Like, while I'm editing this video, I'll go ahead and watch it again. And if I think of anything else while I'm doing it, I'll go ahead and pin a comment or something, guys, because, like, I think there's a lot here. There's definitely a lot here. Definitely, without a doubt. Listen, let me know in the comments of the next thing from him I should be listening to. And if definitely, for example, if he definitely creates deep content like this, I'm definitely interested. Musically, I don't think it was very good though, right? But I think that was a point. Or maybe it was the point. I don't know what it is. I just didn't like it very much musically. It's not something that I would specifically listen to, but the aesthetic of the video itself and how it was actually shot and how everything was staged, everything was great. I think he got his point across. I think, you know, he's basically, I guess the moral of the story I get from this is that he feels that America treats guns better than the victims of said, you know, gun violence. We like our guns, right? We definitely don't want people to be injured by them. But I think when we have this conversation, we need to figure out, right, something serious here. The people who are doing the violent acts are by nature criminals, right? On average, because, you know, I mean, I don't know what the, for example, and I may be wrong because I can only perceive it because I'm around a lot of like 2A people every day. I am, you know, every single day. So I'm trying to figure out, like, are the people who legally own guns the ones committing the crime with the guns, or are the people who are not legally allowed to have guns? Because if those people, I don't know, right? They're already criminals, right? Making an attempt to penalize people that legally own guns, right? Because of criminals that legally do not own guns. It's a weird conversation, I think. All right. Listen, but all right. Let me know in the comments if I should be listening to any more of his music, right? And I will get into that as soon as I possibly can. All right, then listen, you guys all have an amazing day, all right? Enjoy it thoroughly.